Action.
I'm so happy to shoot here in New Zealand. It's the best tour for me. It's like working, but also you get to see all these beautiful scenery.
We found in New Zealand a number of really critical locations to augment our story.
I think that everyone's been quite astounded how beautiful and amazing the locations have been.
Mulan is set in China, and I'm looking for the sort of Chinese aspects within New Zealand, and it did have a lot to offer. We went down to the South Island and the Ahuriri Valley, and then we've come back to the Auckland studios here to film some big key set pieces for this. It's diverse, but a lot of fun to carry out. New Zealand has a way of bringing together people and technology to offer something bright and fresh and epic at the same time.
With a crew the size that we have on Mulan, which is about 850 people, the local benefits in Auckland are quite significant.
The design of the film is massive to reach the epic vision of Mulan. We took 900 people to the Ahuriri Valley to stage an epic battle.
I think for the audience, they'll be very, very pleased and very, very happy to see this. Well,
it was so important to me that the actors have a real space to exist in.
It's like a dream I'll never forget.
Disney's Mulan, streaming September 4.
Our costume designer, Bina, is really good at using color to tell the story.
We had all this research done, which color means what and how we want to use it.
Red is an iconic color in China.
It represents passion, power, and love.
Yifei's costume needed to accomplish a number of things. Firstly, she needed to hide behind it as a male in a man's army. But she also needed to be able to move. So when Yifei moves, the costume really moves with her. Very, very beautiful and quite iconic.
So when did women first start directing movies? Earlier than you might imagine, Alice Guy Blaché was the first woman to direct a movie back in 1896 with The Fairy of the Cabbages, which sadly has been lost since its creation. Incredibly, this is also considered to be the first ever narrative film. Over her lifetime, she founded her own studio, Solex Studios. She directed between 40 and 50 films and supervised nearly 300 other productions. Wow. If you like my show, get one for yourself in the link in the description.